Welcome, everybody, to the second to last week of May for 2019. I'm meteorologist Austen Onek from the News Channel 3 studios in downtown Memphis with yet another presentation of Your Environment, where we take a look at local events. We'll also take a look at current topics involving clean energy, environmentalism, recycling, all that type of stuff going on. And please remember that if you have anything out there in the way of updates or events coming up, recycling efforts, cleanup efforts, neighborhood beautification projects, anything like that across the Mid-South, we'll show you some of the ones that are going to be coming up in the near future and more about how you can get involved easily enough just to help make certain that everybody's taking care of things out there. So again, making the world a better place by making sure we clean up. And if you have events like that, drop them to this email address, austen.onek@wreg.com. Coming up, we'll take a look at Asteroid Day. That's also something, again, that's going to be something to be paying attention to in about 40 days from the United Nations, keeping you updated on the idea of keeping us safe from all the debris that is floating around out there in the solar system. We know about 650,000 known asteroids, comets, and debris like that, but there's a lot out there that we don't know, and that could be the problem someday, so something to think about there. All the website information, again, at wreg.com/weather/environment, or just go to the weather page and, again, click on the button that is up there in the top portion of your screen. You can see that right there showing, again, your environment efforts going on. Hurricane season does not start for about another, give or take, 11 to 12 days, and we already have stuff happening right off of the Bahamas. We have seen a development of a new storm system, possibly a new storm system anyway, giving about 50% chance of developing in the near future. We could be looking at a pre-season storm, depending on how this unfolds. Now, so far, it does not appear to be a major threat, as it looks like it is drifting down to the south and to the east, so away from the United States, the Bahamas, things like that. But once again, definitely want to keep an eye on what's going on, especially if you're heading anywhere toward Florida or the East Coast states, and especially even into the Gulf of Mexico. You got to watch out with what's going on anytime between now and December 1st when hurricane season comes to a close. But as of right now, we could be looking at a preseason storm out there, so keep it tuned for more information on that. For climate information from the Climate Prediction Center, taking a look at what is going on out there where it comes to precipitation and otherwise, we are seeing again what looks to be kind of a middle ground on temperatures for about the next month or so, and then also what appears to be for about the next month a little bit more in the way of a wet period shaping up, especially for the southeastern United States. Again, you can get to more information like that by going to weather.gov and clicking on the Climate Prediction Center. Climate.gov, also a good way to get there for more information on that. Pollen over the next few days, it was a beautiful weekend out there with that rain-cleaned air, but unfortunately over the next few days, looks like pollen is going to be heading upwards and holding pretty steady until the course of the next few days afterwards. So we're just not looking at good news out there for now. Also looking at degraded air quality by just a little bit, but it's getting better. If you'd like to see more about the EPA and how they measure that, you can go to epa.gov or search EPA Air Now for more information about air quality. The air quality down into around the Gulf of Mexico, the southern Gulf around the Bay of Campeche, and into southern Mexico, what you're looking at in this area here south of the Yucatan is wildfires that continue to rage. And we're also seeing, again, the smoke out of this being driven up toward the Rio Grande Valley. Now, last week, it appeared that that smoke might have been aiming toward the southeastern United States. So far, that does not appear to be the case right now, but that's something we're going to need to watch out for. As of right now, Mexico City under a severe environmental emergency warning, thanks to the fact that that smoke is making its way right back over southern Mexico and doesn't appear to be leaving anytime soon. So that could be a problem, especially as these wildfires down here are expected to continue unabated for the next several days and or weeks. So please keep that in mind. Burn bans here in the Mid-South from the Arkansas Forestry Commission. Nothing happening. Very wet spring, so not too much to worry about in the way of tender, dry conditions. From Mississippi, also not seeing any problems. No burn bans being issued at this time. Tennessee, again, does not issue burn bans per se, But they do issue burn bans on a contingency basis as needed. So again, go to burnsafetn.org to find out more details as to what to expect there. Science is an incredible thing to take a look at. It is a neat object, a neat practice to be able to take a look and see at what is going on when it comes to anything involving our world. And being able to find that out is how we, again, learn stuff and make ourselves safer, extend life, make certain that our babies are safer, things like that. So again, we continue to see, again, information brought to us when it comes to things like science, and especially to things like eclipses. People used to be deathly afraid of these things. Now it's more of a gathering to learn more about science than anything else. So by learning about things like science, we can apply it to other things, such as, again, a good lesson from Neil deGrasse Tyson, that no one is in denial of the August total eclipse from a couple of years ago, like climate change, method and tools of science predicted. So taking science as a practice and applying it to other things, like, say, wind power, and the fact that a few weeks ago there was a statement that wind turbines cause cancer, which is absolutely, completely, and totally a fake statement. It does not happen. There is no information to back that up. And as of right now, a lot of places, including the New York Times, Popular Science, Science Alert, the Scientific American retrospect there, National Geographic, and again, keeping all the information out there for right now, again, making a dubious claim, it's your right as an American citizen to do so, but unfortunately, it doesn't guarantee that what you say is true, and that's where science comes in, to take a look at things like that. And that claim from a few weeks ago, wherever that may have come from, again, shows that it is not the case when a lot of agencies take a look into it and find no proof whatsoever that wind turbines cause cancer. And again, that has been pretty roundly debunked in the course of the last couple of weeks. Wind turbines are, again, a good way of trying to make certain that we use clean, renewable energy. And unlike some senators in Congress, we will run out of wind power far, far after we run out of fossil fuels. Hard to believe that some senators actually believe that wind is a finite source and that fossil fuels are infinite out there. Also interesting that the United States Department of Energy kind of hedges their bets by just a little bit by saying that, well, wind power is okay, but, you know, there's other challenges as well and stuff like that. It's a decent down-the-middle look, but it does kind of tend to favor the idea that wind power may not be that acceptable out there. But it's becoming more and more ubiquitous out there, and a lot of people are even using it for the home, to where you can install mini wind turbines. It won't power your whole house, but it will help to knock off a couple of bucks from the utility bill. And you can even, if you make enough money, sell that energy back to your utility provider. And there's tons of great websites available to explore more about that, including the International Renewable Energy Agency, or IRENA, at IRENA.org, to find out more about their work and research into wind power. The American Wind Energy Association, and also several other places, are available to take a look at things like that, including echo-globe.com, to find out more about what it would take to get things like this installed around your property and help save on your utility bills. The information is out there. And wind power, again, does not cause cancer. It also is not that loud for anybody who's spent time around a wind farm, and I'm one of those people, so please keep that in mind. Pick up the plastic out there, 5 pieces a day. Follow their website on Instagram to find out more about how you can reduce plastic pollution every day. The Riverfront Cleanup is coming up this Wednesday from the Wolf River Conservancy. You can also follow them on Instagram. There's plenty other places to go to for information about stuff around here, including Memphis City Beautiful, Sustainable Shelby from Shelby County Government. You can also find out more, again, about what's coming up with the Clean Memphis Commission. And also, again, more about Memphis City Beautiful and all the other stuff around the Mid-South area, available on various social media pages. So some good news on that. Asteroid Day coming up in 40 days, working to keep you safer when it comes to things like asteroids. Find out more of my websites. Go ahead and click on the green button at therainforestsite.com. View the ads. And the sponsors will pay to set aside the rainforest space so that it will never be developed. And so far, the efforts are working. For this year alone, we have set aside, from 7.3 million clicks, 3,677 acres saved so far this year, so it's working. We just need to keep clicking and keep working on saving our planet. That's it for this week. Stay tuned for much more coming up next week. And again, keep it tuned for more at WREG.com/weather.